Hey guys, Josh from SoccerReviewsForYou.com, bringing you a video today on how to properly care for your leather and synthetic soccer cleats using this kit right here. This is the Brazilian Shoe Care Kit. It has a retail price of $24.99, and if you're interested in one of these for yourself, it will be the very first link down below in the description, so be sure to go ahead and check that out. In the video, we're going to take a look at what's included with this kit for $24.99, as well as go step by step on what you should be doing to care for both your leather as well as your synthetic soccer shoes. So with that being said, let's get right into the video. Included with the kit is the following. You can see it comes in this nice little tin box that holds everything. You can store the stuff all in one place when you're not using it, even keeping it in your soccer bag if you want, just so you know where it is at all times. They include this boot shampoo with the built-in applicator. More on this in just a second. They include two colors of leather cream or leather mousse. One is black for black leather uppers, and the other is clear or colorless for pretty much any color. And what's great about these is inside the jar, they include a little applicator sponge that you can store right inside there, so you don't have to have any extra rags or accessories to apply this to your shoes. Everything is all in one here, which I really like. And then they include a wooden boot brush to polish your shoes once you've used all of these products. So that's pretty much it as far as what's included with the kit. Again, for $24.99, you really can't go wrong. It is an all-in-one kit, everything you could possibly need. And now we're going to go step by step on how you should go about caring for your shoes using all of the following products. The first step is very simple and doesn't actually require using any of the products within the leather care kit at all, and it is giving your shoes a quick little wipe down. Now, I have two shoes on the table in front of me. These are the two shoes I'm going to be using throughout the entire video. As my example for a leather shoe, I have the Nike Tiempo Legend 5, and as my example for a synthetic shoe, I have the Adidas Nitro Charge 1.0 Crazy Light. Now, you can see both of these shoes aren't particularly clean. Over time, as you're wearing your shoes, you're going to have a buildup of dirt and grime on the very surface of the upper. It's very evident on both of these two shoes because they are lighter colors. They will be less evident on darker color shoes, especially if they're black. So you can see again, there's just a very fine layer of dirt on the surface of the upper that I would recommend using a wet cloth or even a wet paper towel and just giving the shoe a quick little wipe down prior to using any of the leather care products within the kit. It's just going to make your life a lot easier. It's going to make the actual treatment process a lot cleaner as well in the long run and just make your life easier as well. So again, prior to doing anything to your shoes with the leather kit, I would strongly recommend just giving them a quick wipe down and make them as clean as possible in just a very quick manner by using a wet cloth and wiping them down. The next step, once you've given your shoes a quick little wipe down like I've done right here, involves the boot shampoo included in the kit. Now, like I mentioned, with that first step, you're wiping down the shoe and kind of getting rid of that top layer of dirt that's sitting on the surface of the upper. With the boot shampoo, what you're doing now is removing all of that dirt that has kind of sunken in. It's in the little cracks and creases that can be very difficult to remove, especially with just water and a rag. Now, the boot shampoo, as you can see, comes in this nice little plastic container. Remove the lid, and at the top, you have kind of a foam base and then kind of a wiry, slightly rough textured material right there at the top. And then a little red release valve in the middle. When you push down on that valve, it's going to release a little bit of soap from the actual container. Now, what's great about this is it doesn't require any water, so it is recommended that your shoes are as clean as they can possibly be. Like I said, wiping them down with a rag, as well as dry prior to using this. So again, no added water. And what's great is that it's actually just going to soak into your shoe, so you don't have to rinse them off after the fact. You just let them dry. And even once you're done, if there is any excess soap sitting on the surface of the upper, they just recommend wiping it off with a dry towel or something like that. And again, just let the shoes dry and you're pretty much good to go. Now, the way that you would go about using this is you give it a nice little shake. That is recommended with the instructions right there on the label. You're going to essentially hold it like a pen. You're going to press down on your shoe and you're going to feel the little click from that red release valve in the middle. That's going to release a little bit of soap. And they recommend just moving in a circular motion, a little bit at a time, kind of just going and cleaning certain areas of the shoe one little bit at a time, like I mentioned. So as an area is clean, you move on to the next area. It will take a little bit of time, but you will get your shoes thoroughly cleaned. So I'm going to show you guys in kind of 4x speed me cleaning both of these shoes. So you see them now. Now remember that, because once they're cleaned with the shampoo, they're going to look a lot nicer. Thank you. Alright, so here's a look at the shoes after using the boot shampoo. Please keep in mind that I did it pretty quickly, but even so, it definitely made a pretty dramatic difference in how clean the shoes actually look. You can see it did a pretty good job at getting in the creases of the leather and stuff like that, and really getting as much dirt out of the shoe as possible. Again, if you really take your time and scrub away, you can get some better results. Even taking out the laces and getting to the tongue is something that you can do. I didn't do it here, and especially on the synthetics, I think it worked the best. Really got all of that extra dirt and grime out of the little cracks and creases in the synthetic itself, and really has restored it to make it look almost like it was from brand new, which is pretty impressive. So again, the boot shampoo is definitely a nice touch as far as getting your shoes as clean as possible. And once you've done that, you can move on to step three. The third step involves using leather cream and applying it to the upper of your shoe. Now I have two examples here. The Legend 5 is leather, while the NitroCharge 1.0 Crazy Light is synthetic. If your shoe is synthetic, you do not need leather cream at all. You can apply it to the upper. It's not going to do anything other than make a mess. The reason why you apply leather cream in the first place to a natural leather shoe is because leather is actually the skin of an animal. And just like your own skin, it needs moisturizing every once in a while. After a certain amount of time, it will start to dry out a little bit. And what leather cream is going to do is it's going to rehydrate that leather and make it as soft as it can possibly be. It's not necessarily something you have to do, but if you want to keep that upper as soft as possible and as well maintained as it possibly can be, using something like leather cream is definitely recommended. But again, you don't need to use leather cream. You shouldn't use leather cream on a synthetic shoe. Applying anything to the upper isn't going to do anything as far as its softness is concerned. It's synthetic. It doesn't require moisturizing at all. Just leave it be. Whereas again, with a leather shoe, I would say something like every month and a half is a good time to apply leather cream. It's not something you have to do all the time. If you do it more frequently, it's not something that is going to hurt the shoe by any means. But I would say no more than 1 month to a month and a half at a time is necessary to keep your shoes hydrated, if you will. So with that being said, we're going to move on to how you actually would apply the leather cream. Applying the leather cream, just like using the boot shampoo, is actually very, very simple. You just need to take your time to not make too big of a mess. And again, you want to ensure that your shoes are both clean as well as dry prior to applying anything to the upper. Now, again, they include two colors with the kit, colorless or black. Because this isn't black, you don't want to use the black leather cream. It's just going to make a big mess and stain everything. It won't hurt the shoe, but it might hurt its appearance. So again, because this is a bright yellow color, you want to use the colorless or white leather cream. Now you're going to open it up. On the inside, you're going to find, like I said, the little applicator sponge right there with the little thing to hold it, which is really, really nice. It does have a little tray for that to sit in, so you pull that tray out, and again, you have access to all of the leather cream. So again, I'm going to cut away and show you guys how to actually apply the leather cream to the shoe. So to apply the leather cream, you want to take your little sponge applicator here. You just want to very gently dip it into the actual cream itself. You don't want a ton on the sponge. You can see I have just enough to cover the surface. Again, keep in mind you can always put more, but having too much can make a little bit of a mess. It's not going to hurt the shoe, but again, you want to try and keep this as clean as possible. You basically just want to put it on any leather area of the upper, and you're basically just rubbing it into the surface of the upper. So you can see it is going to get caught in the actual stitching of the shoe. Don't worry, it will dry up and kind of absorb into the shoe. It's not something to worry about. Even if you want to remove the laces, you can. You don't necessarily have to. Again, if you make contact with the laces, it's not a big deal. And again, you essentially just want to rub it in almost like you would cream on your hands or something like that. Just put it on all the areas of the shoe that is made from leather. You can see on this shoe, the heel is made from a synthetic material. Even if it was leather, it's not super important that that part of the shoe is having leather cream applied to it, just because you're not gonna be making touches on the ball there, and it's really not important that that area of the shoe is soft. But again, the main areas of the shoe here that are leather, you really wanna cover with the leather cream and have it absorb into the shoe. You can see instantly it does get shinier when you apply the leather cream. That is definitely something that will be noticeable. And again, when you feel like you've run out on your sponge, you want to just dip it in one more time, get a little bit more, and just keep moving on and covering every single part of the shoe. So it's really that simple. Again, take your time here. My best advice is to, again, not apply too much leather cream to the upper at one time, because it can get a little bit messy. But if you do a little bit at a time, cover all the leather areas of the shoe, it's going to dry a lot more quickly. You're going to have a lot less of a mess. And again, it's really not a hard thing. Something I recommend doing a month to a month and a half every every once in a while. It's not super important to do all the time, but you definitely will notice a big difference in terms of how soft the leather will become once it's dried. So that's pretty much it. I really wouldn't apply much more than that. It's not necessary to put a ton there. You can put more if you want, but I would say that is sufficient as far as treating the leather. And basically, I'm just going to let it dry and give you guys a look at it after the fact. The fourth and final step requires the brush. Now again, if you wanted to do this to the synthetic shoe, you could as well. I don't think that it's going to make too big of a difference here, but the reason why they include a brush in the kit is that once you've applied the leather cream to the upper, there is going to be a little bit of a residue even once it's dried, where it does have that slightly tacky sensation. And again, that's just a little bit of leather cream that has kind of stayed on the surface and dried up, and you have, like I said, that extra layer of residue on the surface. What you want to do with the brush is you just want to kind of brush all the areas that you covered with leather cream, and it's just going to eliminate that little bit of extra residue sitting on the surface of the upper. They say it's a polish. It's not necessarily going to make the shoe shinier. It may, depending on the colorway and the finish on the actual upper. But again, you're just going to eliminate that little bit of extra residue. If you don't eliminate it, it's not going to hurt the shoe. But what it can do is once you start wearing them, dirt will more easily stick to that little surface sticky material that, like I said, is left over. So just give it a quick little brush, and you'll find that the kind of texturing of the upper will change a little bit. It'll come more smooth and more like it was from when you originally bought them. So just wipe them down until you don't feel that residue anymore, and you should pretty much be good to go. Alright guys, that's it for my video on how to properly clean and care for your synthetic or leather soccer shoes. I get questions on this topic all the time, so I figured I'd show you exactly what I do at this very moment with the exact kit that I'm using at this very moment. So again, if you're looking for this kit for yourself, there is a link to buy it down below in the description. $24.99, and includes everything you could possibly need. If all of your shoes are synthetic, perhaps a kit like this isn't the most useful thing for you. The boot shampoo, like I mentioned, is definitely something that I find to be really great. It does help a lot as far as getting the little dirt that seems to be stuck in all the cracks out of the shoe using that boot shampoo applicator thing. But again, if your shoes are all synthetic, the leather cream is not something that you need. And of course, the boot brush isn't necessarily something that you need either. But again, if you have leather shoes and you want to care for them as best as you possibly can, a kit like this is more or less a necessity and a great tool to have if you want to keep your shoes either looking like they're new or just maintaining them as best as you possibly can. So again, step by step, everything was covered in this video. If you do have any further questions, leave those down below in the comment section. I definitely will get an answer out to you. If you have any other video ideas or suggestions, leave those down below in the comment section as well. Always open to hearing what you guys want to see as far as content is concerned. If you found today's video helpful and informative, be sure to support it with a like. That would be greatly appreciated. Subscribe if you haven't already for daily videos on all the latest and greatest soccer gear. You can find all my social media information down below in the description as well. And other than that, guys, hope you enjoyed today's video. And as always, thanks for watching.